The System File Checker, how to run it, and why. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. The System File Checker is a utility included in all versions of Windows these days that can perform a very important piece of work for you. That is, checking system files, as its name implies. But what does that really mean? Well, let's talk about System File Protection and the SFC utility. System File Protection is a technology that was added to Windows some version back that essentially has Windows keeping track of what the quote-unquote official versions of all of the system files are. How it does that is kind of, I'll say, a mystery. It may very well be documented somewhere, but the bottom line is that Windows keeps track of things like probably file size, the time and date stamp, maybe even a cryptographic hash for every file, in that it does this so that it can notice if something changes unexpectedly. The big reason that something might change unexpectedly in the past has been malware. Malware can sometimes come in and try and inject itself into Windows' own system files. Now, Windows detects that and replaces the file with the original official copy. That is something that it does automatically if it notices that things have been changed. Now, files can change for other reasons as well. Malware is the number one reason, but of course, setup programs can occasionally replace system files with unauthorized files or files that it shouldn't be replacing. The scenario that comes to mind is one where a system file tries to update an existing system file with an older copy, whereas the system really does need the newest one to be present. Well, System File Protection will detect that and restore the original official copy. And of course, random other failures, anything from file deletion to disk problems to anything, honestly, anything at all that causes a system file to be somehow altered from what it should be. Now, if you've ever searched for a system file on Windows, you'll find that there are often many copies. And that's one of the places that the repaired copies can come from. Now, unfortunately, malware in particular knows this. It knows that, you know, if I replace this file over here, I should also replace that file over there, the backup copy of the file, and I should also update the database of information that says this file is the official one. It could happen. I don't know that it ever has, but that's something that, in theory at least, malware could do. System File Protection will, in fact, use the backup copy if it can, or it also has the option or ability to fetch that file potentially from a restoration image stored in a hidden partition on your disk, or in some cases, it can even ask for original installation media in order to repair or restore a file to what it should be. So all of this has been happening automatically. For a variety of reasons, it is possible that the automatic stuff can be missed, be it through malicious intent or just some odd, unexpected behavior, like a disk failure, for example. A bad sector on a disk suddenly causing a problem may or may not automatically get detected. That's what the System File Checker is all about. Now, before I go further in talking about it, let's have a look at it. I'm going to bring up the System File Checker. It is a command line utility. We're running Windows 11 here, but the approach is the same in Windows 10. The trick is to run either the Windows Terminal, Windows Command Prompt, or Windows PowerShell in admin mode. After you say yes to the UAC warning, you get a command prompt. The thing to run, I'm just going to run SFC by itself, and you'll see a display of its various options. The option that we care about for this general purpose scanning of what needs to go on is SFC space scan now. That will cause the SFC utility to perform a scan of the entire system. As you can see, it says it'll take some time. The percentage increases as I talk. The point is, though, that this is all that it really takes to run SFC. If a problem is detected, it will either take corrective action right then and there, or potentially warn you that a file could not be repaired, or potentially ask you for installation media or another source for the official version of that file. But the bottom line is that if you're ever asked to run SFC, this is what you do: SFC scan now in an admin command prompt. And if you ever are concerned that perhaps something has damaged your system or has somehow caused a problem, it absolutely does not hurt to run this utility at any time. As we see here, it's going to come to completion, and hopefully it won't find any problems. Microsoft does have more detailed information on SFC, and including the Windows Resource Protection documentation. I'll have links to that information, updates, comments, and more at askleo.com/1896. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.